Hello, Cancer. Here's how you can navigate the energy of the upcoming Mercury going retrograde. And that starts this Thursday, March 22nd, and goes all the way until Sunday, April 15th, 2018. Cancer, you are the nurturer. You are a water sign, either emotionally based. When you are at your best, you are aware of other people's feelings and are sensitive to that. You're family oriented and you're nurturing towards others. You're probably the mom that you make the best cookies and people just love coming to your house and that kind of thing, right? It's just the nurturer. When you're at your work, though, when it's unbalanced, you're over nurturing, like over smothering, mothering kind of thing. Also, because you love your house so much, it's really hard for people to get you out of the house. You'd rather people like come to your house and have a party instead of going anywhere. You can also at your worst be very overly sensitive and moody, and then all to point to defensive. And people who are Cancers as well, Dan Aykroyd, Sylvester Stallone, Jesse Ventura, Harrison Ford, Nelson Mandela, Nikola Tesla, and Robin Williams. He was a Cancer too. Now, what can you do to navigate this Mercury retrograde phase where communication and plans don't go like they should and that kind of stuff? So, if you don't know much about Mercury retrograde, there's plenty of information on the internet. You can check that out. But Cancer, you need to be careful that while you're nurturing others, you don't forget about yourself. So keep listening to yourself. You're going to get a lot of intuitive hits. You are a water sign. You are intuitive. That's natural. Other water signs are Pisces and Scorpio. And you guys are very intuitive naturally because you listen to your emotions. So don't forget about that. You're going to get some intuitive hits during Mercury retrograde. And you need to listen to them. Also, watch for mood swings. Your mood will go up and down during this period, but more so than normal. And don't be so focused on the moodiness and get out of your moodiness into more up here, into the intellectual, using your head more than your heart, so to speak. Because if you stay in your moodiness and stay down there in your emotions, you're going to not be able to see solutions and decisions that were presented to you or that were trying to come to you through your intuition. You will have been so focused on your emotions that you weren't looking at everything else. So make sure you look at the big picture, listen to yourself, don't ignore your feelings. Okay, Cancer, I hope this helps. Visit me on www.themoontree.org. Bye for now. See you in the next video.